Hey everybody, welcome back to The Witcher 3. We ran into a couple of people along the way here. Number one, we had the lady who was looking for some chickens. So we're gonna try our best to help her. And then there's the lady who is probably in more need of our services. We need to kind of defend against these bandits. So the chicken stuff probably... Oh, here
Wolf
we go.
Wolfprint's all right. Though something's not right.
Yeah. Nothing is as it seems. Fair enough. Let's follow the prince. So there was some estimations
Wolf
that...
prints and small footprints next to them, but no signs of struggle.
That it was like a werewolf taking these chickens, but obviously there's something going
little
on
footprints.
Here.
Little footprints. Interesting.
Little footprints could be a numerous amount of things. They must pick up on the other side. Yep, here they are. What could this be? Boy and a girl out here?
Watch APD! He's got a sword! A soldier!
He won't take us alive!
Are you guys sure
not
you want to
hurt you?
Then why are you here? That captain with the black mustache send you?
Don't know any captain. Follow the tracks of the hen-stealing monsters here.
You're a lot of fuss over a few skinny hens. The old lady didn't like them much anyway. She were always yelling at them. And she looks like a witch.
So that doesn't mean you can steal them.
Why are you in the woods? Where are your parents?
Soldiers caught him. We was crossing the river, but they spotted us. We ran, but Mum and Dad had bags, told us to flee.
Lived in the woods alone ever since?
Sure. Find a lot of things, steal a few others. We get by just fine.
And what about these wolf prints? Is that something you guys are behind?
Dad once hunted down a wolf, gave each of us a paw for good luck. We tied him to our shoes.
It's pretty smart.
Because wolves steal hens, right?
Sure. Usually not one at a time, though. You survive by stealing from others. This can't end well. You should ask someone for help.
Who'd help us? Who'd take us?
You'd be surprised.
Once we've got all the hens, we'll go deep in the woods.
Petey says we's gonna hunt where animal hides, so a tent out of leaves.
I'd never grow up.
Okay, Peter Pan.
Last bit's most likely. Good luck, I guess. And watch out for yourselves.
Convince the old woman to take in the children. Exactly. Okay, let's see how this goes. It's a great idea in theory. I just wonder how receptive she's going to be, because truthfully, from going from no kids to three kids you don't know, probably not everybody's idea of a great time.
Hey, Witcher! What is it?
We found those thieves.
Found a group of kids in the woods. They were the ones stealing your hens.
Oh, children, eh? Riding on the backs of wolves, were they?
Never any wolves here. The kids are just clever.
If they've anything in their noggins, they'll stay away from me hen house now.
Yeah, about that.
Take them in. Give them a home. Won't steal from you then.
Sure, but I'll be feeding the whelps. I'll gain nothing from it.
Put them to work.
But... suppose I'll give it some thought.
Alright. I'm going to assume that she's going to take them in, and that'll help me sleep better at night. Now, it is almost... I should have checked the time here. We have Little Red. Wait until dusk. And if we don't get over there soon... we're not going to catch them. That was weird. Then I think we'll probably head off to see Roach. Then we'll probably see Triss. Take care of as many things in Novigrad as we can before we go to Skellige for sure.
Ah,
Whoa. I wonder if this is the site of the famous, cow glitch thing that was going on a while ago. Well, if they're not here yet, I'm gonna take the opportunity to rest. So we can prepare. Okay, if that's who I think it is, let's throw on our hangman's venom.
A witcher? Did the villagers hire you?
Whatever you're planning, plans gotta change. I can't, won't let you hurt these people.
I'm not.
Oh, they're drawing their swords already.
That scoundrel Bertram came to me unbeckoned a half year back. Said he'd betray who's worth looting for a share in the takings, of course. But sometime on, the bugger grew greedy. He wanted more. I refused. That's when he set the witch hunters on us. Lost half me men 'cause of him. Now step aside, witcher. This ain't your affair. We want Bertram, no one else.
As always, the truth is somewhere in between. So, he was getting greedy, wasn't getting what he wanted. I don't know, man. The thing is like, what's to stop them from coming back and terrorizing this place, right? Either way, I don't think we have
don't
a great
decision.
Don't
care much what you say. Take your men and get lost, or there'll be blood.
Oh, there'll
Bertram's
be blood
not in the right either.
You just ensured there'll be more of it.
Whoa! Okay, little red. We did kind of expect that, but that's cool to see it actually happening. I'm pretty sure that's cursed, right? Let's just be sure about it. Yeah, werewolves. And we have enhanced, so this will be good. Now, how am I gonna... Oh, this is gonna be a challenge, actually. This is gonna be difficult just because it's different monster types. Whoa!
Come on!
Oh god.
That's it, you're good for it!
I need to get some instant kills here, guys. Bad. Come on now. Come on. Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Together now! Kill the horses!
Move it, move it. Okay, here we go. Now it's a showdown with the wolf. That's pretty gnarly. damn it. That's gonna be really hard to hit him. There's a good opportunity. Never mind. Yeah, the fire's great.
Wonderful hiding he gave him.
You failed to mention she was a werewolf.
Well, I mean, we wasn't altogether sure ourselves, but that's a good thing. It's what witches are for.
Yeah, you knew.
Killing monsters. Thanks for your help. This is well earned.
Yeah. Either way, that wasn't the best case scenario for anybody, I don't think. It'll pay off, they said. We don't really need that. Just check their bodies. We got everything off of this. We've got like a mother's plea or something, it said. A mother's letter. Dearest Lily, if you're reading this, that means both your father and I are dead. I've asked Eggward to give you this letter only when it is certain neither of us will return. A great deal happened while you were away at the academy. One of your father's ships sank and we fell into debt. I did not write you then because I did not want to worry you, did not want you to return. Your education and future are what matters most to us. Our creditors began to call in our loans and refused to accept payment in installments. When we were forced to admit we could not return the entire sum, they swore to destroy us. Some thugs began following our every step, never letting us out of their sight. It was only a matter of time before the family secret was discovered. They directed the witch hunters to us and were thrown in the dungeon. And we were thrown in the dungeon. I heard the guards gossiping about how we were to have a show trial and a show execution. I gave one my wedding ring and he agreed to allow Eggward to visit us. Your father wishes to give him some final instructions and I want to give him this letter, our last unexpected farewell. Be strong, my sweet, for in your veins flows the blood of men and wolves, and with that comes responsibility. I forbid you to avenge us. That will not bring us life, that will only bring you the executioner's axe. You cannot die, not in that way. You must prove with your life and conduct that men and lycanthropes can live together in harmony. Leave town as soon as possible, take only what is necessary, say farewell to no one. Do not show yourself in public. Journey to where we used to hunt when you were a young girl and brace for the worst. The people there surely do not remember us, but they are good, simple villagers and will treat you with kindness. Let us hope the madness of this persecution will soon end and you will be able to return home. In the meantime, take care of yourself and do not let them provoke you. Remember who you are and do not let anyone convince you that this is something evil. This is how you were born and you should be proud of it. Live for us. We love you, mother. Damn it! That's, really makes you think twice. I mean, I was already thinking twice, but now I'm in it deep. Yeah, that's a tough situation actually, because obviously he was not telling us the full truth. But you don't know how she's gonna react either, right? That's the tough thing. I think it makes sense to, we could go and do the race, or I'm thinking what we should do is maybe go to Roach. Let's see which one is closest. So the race is 900 feet away, roughly. And Roach... is way further. And I actually, are they not on the same... in the same direction, roughly? All right,
go.
Let's
go.
Also, we should just clear this secondary objective that we have here. Oh, you know what? Since it's right there, we can just take the signpost. There's nothing along the way. I feel like we're gonna be pretty unbeatable if we get to run this race here. But it might be kind of a weird time of the day, I'm thinking.
Yes?
Oh, maybe he's sitting up here. The race master.
Wondering if I could take part in the races.
If you've coin for the rider's fee and a steed of your own, why not? Decide quickly, please. There's a race about to begin.
You guys are racing at 2:30? Just tell me about the races first.
These races. Tell me about them.
They're run as per Erasmus Vagelbud's dying wish. He came into his fortune by gambling and remained proud of the fact to the end.
Family doesn't mind having a racetrack right by their house?
But the house, his fortune, would not even be theirs had they not fulfilled Lord Erasmus's wish. He made it a condition.
Any special rules for the races?
They're as simple as Lord Erasmus was. Two competitors, simultaneous start. First to complete a lap around the track, wins.
Sounds easy enough.
I want a race.
Grand. Your name and the name of your steed.
Geralt of Rivia, on Roach.
Excellent. Your opponent, let me see. Seamus Holt, astride Athos.
Competitors, saddle up!
Oh, we waited till morning. Okay, that makes sense.
Three, one, two, three, off you go!
Let's go! See, our stamina lasts so long now with the new gear that we have for the horse. It'd be cool if it gave us an indication, like, of how far along the track we are. I think we're probably about halfway, so I'm just gonna keep going as fast as I can the whole time.
Not looking good.
It's looking pretty good for me. Whoa! That was actually damn close. So I can't make it quite all the way around.
Hear ye, hear ye! The final of the Erasmus Vagelbud Memorial Derby.
Why am I still running then? That was way too close, actually.
Not bad. Yet we shouldn't kid ourselves. The competition was hardly stiff. Shall I sign you up for another?
Do we get to beat, like, different people? Is that what's going on here? Let's see if it, if that's how it works. Yeah, I think so. We probably have to beat, like, a few different people. What did we just get that, oh, we want a superior racing saddle. Yeah, we don't really need this, though. That's the thing. When we compare it to what we have, we've got the exact same thing. It's just really heavy.
Another race.
Like to race again.
Excellent. Don't go anywhere. We'll start soon. Your opponent this time, Viscount Romer astride Caniculus. The Viscount races incognito, so I must ask for your discretion.
Oh, naturally, yeah. Why, who am I going to tell?
Competitors, saddle up!
So I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna slow down about halfway to regain all my stamina and then hopefully make it to the end.
Three! Off you go!
No, Roach, let's go! Yeah, so the first rider was not like the first position rider when it said beat the first rider. Now we have to beat the second rider, but it's a different length of it's a different track, so my estimations are going to be way off. I think it probably makes sense around here.
Letting more felon rubbish yesterday.
There we go. The racing's a bit clunky. Kind of wish they could refine, like, some of the inner workings, but it's not like it's a major thing, so. Damn, I'm a bit worried that we're gonna run out of stamina here. It's a long-ass track. Come on!
Hear ye, hear ye!
Good job, Roach.
The final of the Erasmus Vagelbad Memorial Derby is over. The winner is Geralt of Rivia, riding Roach.
Glory. Good job, Roach.
To the victor.
Bravo! Congratulations, you won in style. Shall I sign you up for another?
I imagine that this is going to be the third and final.
I'll try again.
Gained an appetite, have we? Your opponent this time, Luke Vagelbud, young Lord Albert's cousin, atop succubus. He's the black sheep of the family, but he's not lost a race yet, so he's seen as something of a local champion.
Ah, okay.
Competitors, saddle up.
Let's see what he's got.
On three, one, two, three, off you go.
Let's go.
That's it, Roach.
Wait, where'd he go? Where is he? Oh shit, he's coming now. That was weird. I thought maybe he was, like, cheating or something. I should have taken full advantage of that. Relaxing, actually. It's like a nice little change of pace. I don't know what happened to him again, but we just left him in the dust. I don't know why this guy's the champion.
Vagelbud Memorial Derby is over. The winner is Geralt of Rivia, riding Roach. Glory to the victor.
Good races, everybody.
Fantastic.
Good races.
Fantastic race. Congratulations. A grand victory.
There we go. So what is this, though? 70 stamina. Well, it's even better. Superior cavalry? Absolutely. 70 maximum weight, but we have 100, so we can just get rid of these.
Is there a land where I might find?
All right, cool. Now,
Geralt of Rivia.
Oh, who's
got
this?
It right.
What do you want?
Express my admiration on account of your victory. And here, brought you an invitation from the boss. He'd like to congratulate you personally.
Oh, I bet he would.
Farewell.
Read the letter that we received. This is probably an invitation to Skellige, I imagine. Heard about your victory in Vagelbud's Derby. Such talent should go to waste. In fact, it needs to develop, and make sure it develops, I need to be generously rewarded. If you're interested in either development or the reward, come visit me at my usual headquarters, Varys. Okay. Talk to Cleaver about the letter. That's weird. Okay. So we could talk to Cleaver, I guess. But for now, I am going to go and talk to Roach. This is my top priority. Got a little bit distracted with the races.
Come on. That's it, Roach.
Come on. Now, I don't suppose that we have anything on the way. I think it's pretty clear. Temerian Parisian hideout, or partisan hideout. I wonder what's going to come of this. I wonder if we're going to see, Yorveth. Because I've heard nothing about any potential Squoyatel anything. Besides from playing Gwent with some. Hey, you guys, watch my horse.
You and I'll come on.
You trouble me, Greylocks.
No, I don't kill kings, guys.
Best be worthy. Geralt of Rivia, safe and sound.
So have we not asked them these things? I'm pretty sure that we have.
How do you wind up here?
Came with the army, of course. Its remnants. When Nilfgaard crossed the Yoruga, I dropped everything, threw it all away to hell and rode for the front to fight the invader. Joined the Second Temerian Army under John Natalis. We were to stop the Black One's advance along the Dol Blathana Mount Carbon line. And we did. For 3 days. Then they smashed us into splinters. Soon after, I heard Radovid was assembling his forces near Novigrad. That he'd promised to fight for a free north. Broke through with the remains of Natalis' army, but... But Radovid proved no better than Emir. So I decided I would mount my own fight.
What do you do here, Hunt Squoyatel?
You jest, right? Who cares about the Squoyatel anymore?
Yeah, on point.
Temeria, that's what matters.
So we have heard that before, but just in case you guys hadn't seen it.
Mentioned you have a problem.
It's Vess. She took a couple of lads across the river. She plans to hit the Black Ones at Mulberdale.
That's not going to work out
so,
well.
Sounds about like what guerrilla fighters do.
Yes, when they're ordered to. Whereas I forbade her from leaving camp. Indefinitely.
So, what's going on with you and Vess then?
Don't trust Vess anymore?
Bollocks. She's prepared to die for me. Ah, that's not the problem. Know what distinguishes a soldier from a common swashbuckler?
The uniform.
It's a serious question.
A rhetorical one. So instead of waiting for an answer, just enlighten me.
Soldiers think tactically. They know when to strike, when to fall back, when to charge, and when to hold. Vess finds this difficult. She's impulsive, hot-headed. Yet in guerrilla warfare, one false step and you're fucked.
You got that right.
I confined her to the camp because I feared that sent out she'd go rabid and make a mistake. I was right.
Yeah, but typically if you're going to tell somebody straight up, like, you cannot do this and you don't provide a lot of context, they're going to want to do it even more.
Why Mulberdale? Why'd Vess go there?
The peasants from the village aided us earlier. The Nilfgaardians learned of this. Word got out they're planning a punitive expedition. Probably hang every fifth villager.
Honestly, Vess's desire to save the villagers makes sense. What doesn't is your opposition to the plan.
War means death. Not only for the soldiers, for the common folk as well. You can't save them all, it's that simple.
Funny.
So we've learned.
Had you for an idealist.
You were right to. Are right to. But I have one ideal. A free Temeria. And I'm prepared to sacrifice anything for it.
All right, so you've got a problem. Insubordination. What am I supposed to do about it?
I doubt Versus entered the village. More likely she and the boys lie in wait in the woods nearby. We must find her before she attacks and stop her. You're a good tracker. Help me.
I wouldn't come all this way and tell him we're not going to get involved.
Count me in.
Thanks, Geralt. I'll owe you a favor. Meet me in Velen beneath the Hanged Man's Tree.
Hey, I know where that
it's
is.
It's just a short jaunt from there to Mulberrydale.
And we know Mulberrydale as well. We've been there.
Now, witches. They can't catch the pox. Didn't that work?
Yeah, that's right.
It's true, you kill kings.
We're a bit immune. So this is a good time to probably jump over. Actually, you know what? There's a couple of things along the way. What if I went to the White Eagle Fort and then came down through here, this undiscovered place? We'll just ride over. We're at the troll. Oh, I'm gonna have to swim across for sure. Sorry, Roach. To the other side, please. Oh, good job. You did well. Whoa! That could have been real bad. Broken legs and the like. Look at those little guys. They're so cute now. Let's leave them be. Devil's Pit. How does one enter the Devil's Pit?
Come on.
What the hell is this? Oh, it's a bandit camp.
Get him! Come on!
He's ours! Hot tower!
What could I possibly need in this bandit camp? Because truthfully, I'm a little bit overburdened as it is. And I think it would make sense to come back here when we can grab a whole bunch of stuff. That's what I'm gonna do. It looks interesting. I'm not sure what lies in the bottom, but I feel like we've seen a similar pit to this in the past.
Guardians already. They're preparing to execute folk.
No sign of Vess.
She may be impetuous, but she's not stupid. She's waiting for her moment. Probably attack after dusk once.
Shh.
What now?
trio, lightly equipped, sneaking closer over there near the...
That's so cool. Oh, there she is.
Circa!
Looks like we're too late.
Let's motor.
Follow me.
Sorry, guys, we crashed. And we got to this little village and then just died, so I figured we'll run in from here. Okay, Vess, we're gonna have to protect her. Oh my god, so strong! That was good. Where the hell is Vess here? She's getting hurt already. Oh, here she is.
Brave enough, barbarian.
Holy shit, she's almost dead. Maybe she can't die. I'm thinking she can't die here, which is great.
Come on.
These friggin' arrows. Go. Come on, Vess, let's go, let's go.
That's fine, no.
Great.
Anytime you want to help, Roach, would be great. Just one little backstab there, maybe? No? I'll handle it, thanks. Jesus.
God damn it, Vess. Have you gone completely mental? You ignore my orders, go off on a suicide mission, and instead of donning a breastplate, you dash into battle, shirt open, navel and... what not exposed?
You're not my father, Roach. You've no right to tell me what to wear.
But I am your commander, and you will obey me. Guerrilla warfare. Warfare! It involves armies, for fuck's sake.
I could not abandon them. They helped us.
It's a soldier's job to kill, Vess, not save, not rescue. If that is not to your liking, join the Sisters of Melitele. Study to be a healer. Fucking hell. Give me your weapon. You'll get it back when you wise up. If you wise up. Move out!
Uh-oh.
Ren.
Yeah, definitely taking prison. Prisoner.
Uh-oh. Got yourselves a prisoner.
We don't take prisoners. You took my weapon, Roach. So I must manage with my bare hands.
Leave him alone. Corpses enough here.
What?
You heard me.
I did, and I can't believe it. He came here to murder civilians. He's seen us. Will you have him return to his camp and report?
Emir knows we can kill his men. Let him learn that we can also show mercy.
Oh my god. I'm almost willing to say just kill him, but it's not about, like, I don't want any trouble. Like, that I'm not worried about. And that's the reason I'm going to disagree with that.
Roach is right. Besides, killing a defenseless...
What is it with you, Roach? Did the Witcher take your stones? They're sadists. He's the occupier.
I will explain later. You, Nilfgaardian, piss off.
Morentai. Nes dirmad ava.
Go, before I change my mind.
I wonder if in, like, war like this, where, you know, one side kind of spares an important person from the other, if that's actually taken into consideration.
Thank you, Geralt.
For anything.
Ever need any help, you know where to find me.
I'm kind of unsure, like, about their relationship. It's a bit bizarre, because, truthfully, like, Vess, she... I don't know. I just feel like she kind of was like rebellious teenager mode a little bit. Oh, that's kind of strange. I'm not sure how to interpret that. I'm gonna jump up here to Lucian's windmill, go and play Gwent against this Scoia'tael. Zeracanian powder? Oh, look at this. Wild Hunt Warrior Axe. Whoa, look at that. That's cool. They have some interesting gear. They do. Oops. Oops. Knight's Gauntlets? Might be worth checking out. Nope. And when I get to a next city, by the way, I'm gonna be, like, before I record next, actually, I'm going to be going in and selling a whole bunch of our duplicates and stuff that we don't need, so that I don't have to deal with this burden problem anymore. Because it's, yeah. I'm really holding on because of the update that should be coming, and I'm really thinking that it's going to be, oh, nice, we can actually wear these. I really do think that it's going to be about the storage. I think that's going to be really cool if that's the case. And then that way I can keep all of my Witcher gear, like, I just kind of want to keep sets of stuff, you know? But I certainly could get rid of probably 40 pounds worth of junk, say, like, that I could just sell at a regular merchant, so. Let's head up to Lucian's windmill, and then we're right there. Now, if the Scoia'tael deck is not playing, or if the Scoia'tael group is not playing with a Scoia'tael deck, I will be blown away. Yeah. Also, I was talking the other day about upgrading some of my, like, blade oils, like the necrophage oil and stuff, and I need bear fat for a lot of things, and, it's kind of a weird thing I haven't seen. I could probably buy it from a merchant somewhere. Or maybe this guy.
It's you! I'll never forget you. I must thank you once more.
Who are you?
You know me?
Is he the guy?
We met long ago in Broccolon.
Possible, but can't say I remember.
No surprise. You were badly wounded then. If not for the Dryad's care,
oh, okay.
You would have survived.
Like going way
long
back.
Long time ago. So long it feels like it happened in another life. Maybe that's not so far from the truth.
Okay, so he does sell things.
Be glad to glance at what you're selling.
That's a cool little throwback. Ooh, hi. What does he got here? Monumenta Elforum, Elven Sages. I don't know if we have this book, so we're gonna grab this. That's a pretty cool blade. Significant improvement over our steel sword. Very pricey. But I think it makes sense to grab it. It's expensive, but we're not spending our money on, like, anything, really. Now we could sell him, like, we could sell him the Warrior Axe. It's not gonna get as much as it could at, a blacksmith or a weaponsmith, but truthfully, that's not our biggest benefit right now. We just kinda need to clear some space. Do we need diagrams for runestones? Not really. And he doesn't have any of the bear fat that I was talking about. But, let's play him in a round of Gwent.
You play Gwent?
Do you really have no one else to play with?
Always nice to play someone new.
Fine. Beggars can't be choosers, after all. I'll play you. And even stake one of my unique cards.
Okay, cool.
Pull out your cards.
So I think we just rock with our regular deck here. It is going Scoia'tael. Let's see if it's just the extra card. Nice. Couple of blue stripes. No decoys, though. Don't have double Crinford Reavers. Catapult. And we do have two pretty strong cards, though. But I think I'm going to get rid of Kira for the decoy and Sheila. That's an interesting draw. Pick a Biting Frost card from your deck. Okay, we can counter that pretty straightforwardly. So far, I'm not seeing anything major. Okay, now this could be serious here, depending on what this brings out. That's not bad. But so far, I'm underwhelmed with his deck. Torrential Rain doesn't bother me. I can clear that. I'm gonna play back here to see if she'll... Or see if he'll just get comfortable and then end up passing. Yeah, beautiful. I could clear my weather now, but then I'm not going to be able to clear it when I play my guys up front. But I will have 20 guys up there to take care of it. I think what I'll do is maybe decoy one of the cards back and play our... Oh, our Reaver's only going to put us at a tie. That was really miscalculated. Really miscalculated. Kelly, you know what? In that case, I'm going to let him take this round. He's only got 4 cards left. And I feel pretty confident that we could take him. Oh, shit. Whoa. I've never seen something so strong. It's Siri. That's so cool. I want that. See how this goes. She's only got 2 cards left. What's that gonna do for you? Now we know what one of the cards is. Throw down some fog, sure. But that other card, that's not even gonna help. She put it on the front line, maybe. I kinda hate to do this, but... It doesn't really matter, because with one card, there's nothing he can do. She may freeze the front. If she does that, I drop by 4, but so does she, so... Yeah, nothing he can do. I keep saying she because of the Squirtle leader card there, but, it's a he. Good game.
Damn it all, I'd so hoped for victory.
I hope that's a Siri card.
So be it. You've won the card fair and square.
I really hope it's the Siri card.
What a ride!
Come on, show it to me, show it to me, show it to me. Yes! Oh, that is sick! That is super, super, super good. Yeah, that is really good. I think that's gonna replace Zoltan. Yeah, very cool. Okay, we have a great deck now. Oh, and Francesca Findebear. Did not know that we would have 2. Wait, where's... Oh, we have the... It's the leader card. Yeah, cool. All right, cool. Well, tell you what, guys. We're going to take a bit of a break. Maybe... Where are we going to head next? Because... Might be worthwhile just to kind of get there. So that we can pick up right away. This episode, I know, is maybe a little bit slow because of the horse racing. And Roach's thing was actually super, super fast. I did not think it was going to be that quick. So, yeah, I'm thinking what we could do is go and meet Dandelion at the Rosemary and Thyme. Or we could... Let's see. That is pretty close by, actually. If I check this one... That is also close by, so we can just do both. But what we'll do is head back into Lucian's windmill, and we'll just jump over there because there's really nothing in between. So if you guys want to drop off now, that's totally cool, but I am going to hit the sign, and we'll be into Novigrad shortly, and we'll pick up from there. So thank you guys so much for the support, and we'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.